12 years after it was announced, NASA's massive space launch system finally will make its public debut. But first, what's called a wet dress rehearsal is planned in early April as the final major test for the Artemis 1 mission to ensure that all systems are a go for the actual launch from NASA's Kennedy Space Center. News 19's Archie Snowden joins us now with more on this historic launch.
Okay, thank you, Greg. NASA teams from across the country have been working diligently leading up to this milestone known as Rollout and making preparations for wet dress rehearsal, a much anticipated development, a launch system that has been beset by delays.
NASA's top technicians are excited to finally get the mission going, moving the SLS from the Vehicle Assembly Building to the Launch Pad 39B for a wet dress rehearsal. It's been a long time coming. Congress directed NASA to develop the SLS to replace the Space Shuttle rocket back in 2010, but after repeated setbacks and technical issues, the Rollout is all systems go.
You know, there's been a lot of testing going on with the rocket, but there are literally thousands of component-level tests and system-level tests that have occurred.
SLS is prepared as a vehicle that will return humans to the moon and possibly even further into the solar system. But on Thursday, the 6-million-ton Crawler Transporter 2 will carry the rocket to the launch pad. Once the rocket is on the pad, the team is expected to conduct the wet rehearsal, which will consist of several more pre-launch mission tests.
We do get into our booster servicing ops, and we'll do our servicing of the boosters. We'll load the hydrazine there, and then we'll get into our wet dress preps. And then we'll get into wet dress itself, which will run about 2 days. It'll very closely follow what we would do for launch countdown.
While the wet dress test will occur in Florida, it would not be possible without the work done in Alabama. Marshall Space Center Director Jody Singer says it's a dream come true.
Working with the Space Launch System and seeing the Artemis program and being part of returning us back to the moon is one of those things that is just a dream come true.
Now, if all goes planned, the wet dress rehearsal will start on April 1st and the test will run until April 3rd. Now, NASA will be using the same launch room they did when they launched Apollo 11 back in 1969. So, Greg, exciting times once again at NASA.